guys. Today we are basically just going to be doing some more work on the 34. So in today's video, we're just going to be installing this eBay front lip on the car. Now this is a Rhino front lip, so it's made of rubber. Thought the front lip would come with hardware, but it didn't. So we just had to quickly run to the store and get some self-tapping screws and some washers for the install. And because it's going on the front bumper, it's just going to be into the plastic. Self-tappers will be fine. I don't have to rust proof anything or do anything like that. Now this eBay front lip is just a Rhino front lip, so it's made of rubber. The reason for getting a rubber one is basically just because I didn't want to spend $600 on a front lip and knock it off because the car's going lower. And that plastic. This is basically the same height as the front lip I was going to get, which is the Ace or the AC front lip for the Series 1 front bar. But yeah, so I've heard good things about this ship, so hopefully it works. It's cheap as, it was only $40 delivered. So yeah, we'll see how it goes and see what it looks like. So this is what it looks like now. And this Rhino lip basically just sits under it like that. And so here we go, we'll see how it looks. Alright, so the first thing we gotta do for this install is take the front bumper off. So just gotta pop the bonnet so I can take my cooling panel off and undo it from the top, and then after it's undone from the top, we'll have to do it from the wheel wells. So before you guys go and try and hose me, no, the front mount is not connected. It's still running the side mount intercooler. This is just because basically when I bought this car, they had it set up as a return flow. So they just had like a 180 degree silicone hose to a straight pipe and then piped up to the stock intercooler piping. One day when I was driving, I hit a speed bump and it actually cracked that bottom pipe. And because it's not actually a proper return flow cooler, and yeah, blah blah blah. Got the plenium that's got to go in there, that's why we did the battery relocation. If you haven't seen that video, check it out. And that's why I haven't bothered piping it back up, because we actually need to get some custom piping made up to go up through under where the battery used to be and to a forward facing plenium. There's no point taking it out or anything like that. The car is turbo, it's not like I'm posing as a non-turbo car with a fake intercooler or anything like that, but it will be getting piped up soon and you guys will see that video. I can't wait to get rid of this fucking stock intercooler, to be honest. Alright, so back over to the bumper. The bumper's off and now we're going to do an install. Alright, so basically we're going to be needing to install this Rhino lip onto your front bumper or your skirts or wherever you're going to put it. You're just going to need some washers, self-tapping screws, drill, screwdriver, and cutters or scissors. I'll show you why you need them soon. You just got to put relief cuts in the bumper on the corners. But yeah, we'll jump into it and show you how it's installed. Alright, so as you can see, I've put the first screw in. This is in the center of the bumper, in the center of the lip. You want to put the washer right where the ridge is. There looks like there's a dimple in there now, but that's only because these sides are falling down. Once they're pulled up straight, there's no dimples in it. You want to put the washer right on the ridge so it reinforces it, so that it's nice and sturdy. We're just gonna keep going along and doing that, and I'll show you how to do the relief cuts when we get there.
Alright, so you'll notice when you get to the corners and things like that, the inside likes to poke up like that. This is where you do your relief cut. This is basically just a V in there, and this will sit flush again. That's why I did one either side and not in the center. So yeah, we'll do a relief cut in there and that'll all sit down normal, but so far it's going on pretty good. Doesn't look too bad. We'll see how it looks when it's finished. So I just flipped the bumper out like this just to check it out, and I just had a good idea. With these side bits, I might actually just fold them and screw them up on the bumper, because it actually looks pretty cool if you guys can see it on the camera. It doesn't look too bad actually, so yeah, we might do that, but that's basically the lip. See how long it lasts. Throw it on the car, give you guys a better look. And yeah, that's about it. Lips all done, gonna put the bumper back on the car, and I'll show you guys what it looks like. Alright guys, so bumper's back on, the lip is on, and yeah, it doesn't look too bad actually. It's actually a bit solider than I thought. Fit pretty good I guess, like there's not any wrinkles or bumps or anything like that. We'll see how long it lasts. Hopefully I don't scrape too much. For all you guys wondering, that is how much lower it sits, so about 2.5-3 centimeters, about an inch. Doesn't look too bad, pretty happy with it. Next we got the side skirts and rear pods going on. They're at the body shop at the moment. I should get them back tomorrow, so those should be the next video. Alright guys, so that pretty much sums up the front lip. It's a nice easy one for you, it cost me $30 delivered. That is a Rhino lip. I'll put the link in the description for you. It's just a hard rubber lip, so you can bash it around and it won't break basically. It is very strong. Hopefully it lasts. It does look pretty good. And yeah, so at the moment, the skirts and rear pods are in the shop getting painted, so that'll be the next thing going on, which will be the next video, which should be tomorrow. So yeah, make sure you check that out. Thanks for watching, guys.